Skagit Valley's waters are often too warm. It's happening to rivers and streams in many Puget Sound watersheds. But the Skagit provides much of the salmon that feed people, orcas, and other wildlife, and inspire human culture in Puget Sound. Right now, warm water is damaging the salmon runs in Skagit Valley. There are things each of us can do to help fix the problem. Each action adds with another and the next. Together, we can keep the Skagit wild and cool and protect this special place that we love. Businesses, farms, nonprofits, individuals, and state, local, and tribal governments are coming together to find creative solutions. A lot of work has already been done. So far, over 700,000 native trees and shrubs have been planted along Skagit Valley streams. There are two main ways to restore land so it helps keep stream water cool. The first and simplest is to increase shade by replanting trees along streams. The second is to let rainwater soak into the ground. Groundwater stays cool as it flows to streams, and it gives streams a steady flow of this cool water that lasts late into the summer. We help this groundwater flow when we reduce pavement or install rain gardens. With help from local organizations, farmers are helping lower water temperatures by planting trees and shrubs on their stream banks. And so are residential landowners with streams running through or near their properties. We'll take a closer look in this video series at these efforts by streamside farmers and residential landowners. There are many good reasons to plant trees and native shrubs. They benefit both humans and wildlife.
Also, one of the benefits is that it provides an area where you don't get as much erosion coming off. So as a farmer, it's nice to know that the nutrients that you're putting on a field have less chance of running into a waterway.
The plantings I've done here have changed my property tremendously. I can sit on my back porch and birds just like fly over my head all the time. There's so much a cacophony of beautiful sounds here.
What I do know is that when there's shade on the stream, it's cooler. And knowing what I know and what little I know about how the whole system works together, if one thing goes out of whack, you don't know what's gonna make it collapse. And so we don't need to push that line. We gotta do more.
You don't need to own property on a stream to help. Install a rain garden to safely soak roof water into the ground. Join a volunteer work party to plant shady trees and shrubs along a stream. We are the key, and it is our responsibility to preserve the wild, cool nature of the Skagit. In our next two videos, we'll meet streamside landowners and hear their stories, and local experts will take us to see programs and resources available to support stream restoration. Visit our website to learn more about Skagit Valley's warming waters, and how each of us can be what makes Skagit waters cool.